Excellencies, ladies and gentlemen, all courtesies observed. Looking out from Apia to the beautiful blue Pacific, it's difficult to accept that the ocean is in deep trouble. But the science is incontrovertible. Thanks to the effects of GHG emissions and the altering of our planet's atmosphere, the ocean is being subjected to warming and acidification with profound consequences, such as the die-off of coral, changing ocean currents, migration of marine life, and rising sea levels, to name a few. To meet the challenges of these changing conditions, in 2015, all 193 member states of the United Nations agreed to the 2030 Sustainable Development Agenda, containing within it the Oceans Goal, SDG 14. Taken together with the Paris Climate Agreement, this represents our universal plan to reverse the cycle of decline in which the ocean's health is currently caught. As a loving grandfather, I'm confident that this plan will succeed and that I'll go to my grave confident that the generations to come will have a secure future on this planet. But that confidence can only be well placed if all of us are true to the implementation of the plan, if all of us defend the integrity of the plan that we have set for ourselves. So it's a great pleasure for me to be addressing you today at the Samoa Partnership Dialogue. You know, since the concept was first introduced during the World Summit on Sustainable Development in 2002, partnerships have come a long way in contributing to SIDS efforts to meet their sustainable development goals. The 2014 SIDS conference in Apia emphasized partnerships as a key means of supporting SIDS to address their inherent vulnerabilities and to explore new ways of collaboration. What is more, the 2030 agenda recognizes that partnerships are critical to the implementation of the Sustainable Development Goals. The ambition and breadth of the SDGs make them simply unattainable without robust and durable partnerships. Like climate action and ocean action, when it comes to sustainable development, we are all in this together. The SIDS Partnership Framework and its Intergovernmental Steering Committee on Partnerships for SIDS were a key outcome of the Samoa pathway, formed as they were to monitor progress of existing and stimulate the launch of new, genuine and durable partnerships for the sustainable development of SIDS. This is an innovative arrangement and is the only intergovernmental process within the UN tasked with monitoring and following up on multi-stakeholder partnerships. I particularly like to commend Belize and Ireland, the co-chairs of the steering committee, for showing remarkable leadership in following up on existing partnerships and advocating for the launch of new SIDS partnerships. I also applaud their leadership in presenting the SIDS partnership criteria and norms, which brings further clarity to what constitutes genuine and durable partnerships for SIDS. As you know, a year ago, we gathered in New York for the first UN Ocean Conference in support of the implementation of SDG 14. The conference was a historic event with thousands of high-level participants from member states and the UN system and other intergovernmental organizations, as well as the full participation of civil society and the scientific community, the private sector and other relevant stakeholders. The conference resulted in ambitious outcomes, including an intergovernmentally agreed political declaration, Our Ocean, Our Future, Call for Action, and over 1,400 voluntary commitments from the governments and UN system and IGOs and major groups and other stakeholders to advance the implementation of SDG 14 and related targets. A large part of these commitments directly impact SIDS, and many of those announced were from SIDS themselves. To follow up on the implementation of these voluntary commitments, to catalyze and generate new voluntary commitments, and to facilitate collaboration and networking amongst different actors in support of SDG 14, we have established 9 thematic multi-stakeholder communities of ocean action. And you can find out more about these communities and how you can participate in them by visiting oceanconference.un.org. The communities have proven to be extremely useful in maintaining multi-stakeholder interest and engagement in ocean action. and could perhaps serve as an inspiration for strengthening the review mechanisms around partnerships for SIDS. I wish you a fruitful dialogue, with the hope that you leave today's meeting in Apia invigorated by the progress being made on SIDS partnerships and determined to pursue the many possibilities that new partnerships offer. Fafetai Lava.